Damn, walleye, lucky.
All right, back in the hole she's going, guys.
Release into the knot grease. Oh shoot, their camera head fell down. Whew. All right, guys, it's been a long day, but welcome back to another video. If you are new here, my name is Kit. We're gonna be doing some ice camping. So funny story is, it is about 4 p.m. right now, almost 5 actually, and we've been up since 5 o'clock, been driving for like 4 or 5 hours just to end up about an hour away from the house. So the lake we wanted to go to, it was like 2 posts with a spud bar water. Driving to that spot, man, there were ponds all the way open. We probably hit, I don't know, 4 or 5 different bodies of water. Fished one, caught some bluegills, but man, if I just wanted to camp somewhere and catch bluegills, I might as well do it a little bit closer and where I could get a higher number of them. So here we are. I'm slowly getting set up. I don't even know if I'll be able to fish at the beginning, but we'll see. I still got a whole bunch of stuff to set up. Got to put up my lights and stuff. I just figured I might as well do an intro while I can. All right, now it's getting dark. Well, let's try to pick up a few fish before it gets too dark, and then I can finish setting up. Took me a while to set up, but here we go. See if I pull up a fish over here. Yeah, got so much room. Oh, come on, buddy. Come on. Hopefully it's not too late. It's pretty dark. It's like after 5 right now. If I catch a bluegill or something, maybe I'll use them as cut bait. Let's try to catch one bluegill or a crappie. Use them as bait. No, where you going? Come on, buddy. Oh, something looking at my tungsten. Gonna hit it? Come on, he's coming. Hit it. Hit it, you mofo. Okay, drop it down to his buddies. Ooh, come on. Turn around, dude. Oh, this guy sees it. Oh, he missed it. Come on, bluegills. Or crappies. Ooh, got a high roller. Come on. Where are you? Come on, buddy. No. Went away. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Got a couple high rollers here. Come on. Come on. Ooh, he sees it. Sees it. It's coming. Come in. Huh? You son of a bitch. Oh, what's this? There we go. What do we got here? Feels like a crappie. Oh, here we go. Decent little crappie. Came up from that brush pile. Hey, you want to throw them in the corner where my boots are? Chill, 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 chill. I'm going to have to whack that guy on the head. And he made a mess over there. Oh, nice.
Nice fish, dude.
Eater size.
You going to eat him or let him go? Check out this fish butter's just caught. Hey!
Oh no, he looks pretty tasty.
Up to you. I mean, we got gills, but it don't matter.
We'll put him back.
Alright, you want to put him, want me to put him back?
You can put him back.
Alright, cool. Butter's fish, I can't take no credit for this.
He caught Maki Maki motor oil.
Wow.
Clam.
He took plastic off.
And black chicken.
Nice fish, dude.
Thanks, buddy.
Oh, I see him going down.
I didn't even freaking put it on the film because I'm not recording, but.
All right.
He crushed it, dude.
D, lucky. Okay, we're gonna bonk this crappie real quick, just so we have some meat down there. Okay, we're gonna put some meat on this spoon. And hopefully that camera's bright enough over there. These lights aren't super bright, but better than no lights. Oh, there's a big fish down there. I didn't hook the meat very good, but we're getting down. No, come back. No, I was too busy putting the meat on. Okay, here we go. Hopefully you guys can see that chunk of crappie going down on a spoon, rattle spoon. Oh, of course, by the time I get back down, it's too late. Too late. Keep scooching closer and closer to you guys. Come on, there's been one fish kind of suspended over that brush pile. He's not moving. Oh, never mind, he's moving. Moving the wrong way. Hooty-hoo!
You guys clean the fish?
I'm not. Oh, I got one.
You want a little wash?
Oh, dang. See, we got gills, so I think I'm okay.
Okay.
You maybe ask Butters, but he just let a walleye go, too.
Okay.
But so thank you, sir.
Just Jack.
Yeah, I heard you causing some commotion over
there.
Yeah,
trying to make a good video.
Yeah.
I had the camera off when I actually caught it, so I had to let it back down the hole.
Oh, rats. All right, that was Ryan with the Tazzler Guide Service. He just happened to be out here. We came out of here and saw three people. And we're like, wait a minute, I know that guy. Man, I set up way too late. Oh well, it is what it is. Ooh. Oh, big fish. Come on. That was a kitty. Oh, dude. That was a kitty for sure. Oh my God. Dang it. Pretty sure that was a catfish. He was long, creeping up to it. Guess it could have been a walleye too. Oh, something's coming. Oh, there's a bigger fish coming out of the brush pile. Come over here, fish. You know what, I'm gonna reel this up and drop the spoon down there. You know, no I'm not. Leave the spoon over here. Oh, here he comes. No, why? Dude. Such a big mark. That had to be a big catfish. Dang it. Come on, man. Alright, guys. Fishing has been really slow. Hold on. I'm pretty sure you can hear that flopping around. But, yeah. Whoa. Lens is foggy. Let me wipe you guys off. I got a little vignette going, but hey. Second nighttime crappie now. It's been pretty slow. I've been marking some big fish, but they've been kind of tentative. I'm guessing they're either catfish or walleyes. I'm guessing the more darty guys are walleyes and the slow creepers are catfish. But here we go. I guess 6 o'clock. Is it nighttime yet? I think it's about nighttime. So here, nighttime crappie. We'll let them back. Actually, you know what? We're going to eat this guy for lunch tomorrow. Never mind. Gonna bonk him on his head. I won't show you guys that though. Oh, something else creeping around. There's stuff moving around, but they're like super slow moving. Oh, I had him. I don't think I set the hook hard enough on him though. That was a problem. Okay, so we got another guy down there. He's just creeping super slow. See if I can get him to come in and eat. If I get him to notice me, just like that last guy, he should come in and eat. Oh, wait a minute. He's getting really close. Oh, he sees me. I think he sees me. He's coming. There we go. Yeah, it's just a slow going process. Okay, chill. Getting water everywhere. Here we go, guys. Another nighttime crappie. Yeah, this is why I brought a towel with me, because man, once you get a fish up here, they just make such a mess. Well, I should just keep this out. There's another fish down there. Let's get down. Should be able to get right down in front of him. No, no, no. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, I'm going to conserve some battery. So I'm going to turn you guys off, even though I got like so many battery packs and power packs with me. We'll be back, hopefully with a fish. Or maybe I'll be eating steak, because Butters is cooking steak right now. Oops, I did not realize that that rod was dangling right there the whole time. But freaking Butters, what a guy, man. He made a steak. Look at that, looks dope. I got a little something, a little special something to go with it too. All right, I'm gonna cut this up. New York strip, I think. And put on my special sauce.
Where am I going,
kid? Right there.
This one, the same door?
Yep, same door. Let me put my plate down. The only thing you gotta watch out for is there's some crappies right there.
Oh, stacking up some bait, are you?
Yep, stacking up some lunch. Got the fish looking at my stuff.
I think I got 9 over there. I'm
gonna guess. Yeah, you just step in and then take off your bits. There you go, sir. Fish. You know, all the fish I've been catching are splashing all over anyways.
What are the fish doing anyways?
Just creeping and being dumb.
Being stupid, not doing anything?
Yep.
Oh, I'm caught.
I think we're good, Ryan. Thank you, though.
Take care, buddy.
Oh, that's what a brush pile looks like.
Yeah, the fish are just creeping super slow.
Super slow.
Anyways, that camera's on. You got anything to say? Say what's up.
It's been an adventure today, to say the least.
Oh, yeah.
But I got no complaints right now.
Dude, I should have set up way earlier. I think by the time I got done setting up, the fish were kind of into their nighttime mode. That's all right, I still got, what, 3 fish on the ice over there?
Not bad, not bad.
Packing gonna be a though.
I'm definitely making 2 trips again.
I'm super comfy now, but tomorrow's gonna suck. At least the weather won't be bad.
I don't even have my heater rolling right now.
I didn't have it going, but then I started getting cold.
I turned it off because I was cooking. Figured we could eat a bougie meal for once out here.
Right.
Not that the tacos aren't bougie, but...
Asian tacos, right?
Oh, that's got a hell of flavor.
Yeah. Let me give you some of my sauce. Pineapple pepper sauce. I just put it in the corner somewhere.
Just throw it right there.
So I think it's pretty good.
This is the stuff that's been turning you up.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to eat it where I don't have a bathroom within.
There's one over there.
Oh, outside?
Yeah. Oh, there's a couple fish moving through. Ooh, can I get one with a plate on my stomach? Or with a plate on my lap? There's one looking at my cut bait, too. No, they're both going away. No. No. That's all they've been doing, man. Just creeping.
A sweet, but I can already taste the spice, like, instantly. Like,
yeah. It's got 6 peppers in that little container.
What? Right that there. Sauce is good.
Be better on the fish.
Find out tomorrow.
Yep. Alright, I'm gonna let you guys go. We're just gonna sit here and eat. Unless we catch something crazy, we'll catch up later.
Look at that. Those guys are cruising higher than hell.
Okay, alright guys. Hey, eating my steak. A fish came through and I was able to pick him off. I think I'm gonna keep, yeah, probably just this one more guy and save them for lunch tomorrow or breakfast or whatever we decide to do.
You got eggs and bacon.
Yeah, got eggs and bacon for breakfast. Then maybe lunch out here or maybe lunch back at home. I don't know. All right, I'm going to bonk this guy and we'll catch up later. All right, guys, working a fish here. See if I can catch him on camera. Instead of showing you guys after. Oh! won't show him to you guys at all. Dang. Come on, bud. Nope, just keep going. Just keep going. You son of a gun. Okay, it was worth a shot, I guess. Alright, guys. There's a fish down there. Let's see if I can work him in. Oh, he's moving. Think about these nighttime fishes. They move really slowly. Oh, he dunked it. Oh, play it, peel and drag. Oh, dang! Hey, another nighttime crapper. Yep, nighttime crapper. This guy was creeping real slow, creeping on a come up. And he hit the drastic plastic right here on the Saki rod. Hey. But I think I'm gonna let this guy go. We got four crappies there. Butter's got a few bluegills on the ice over there too. I see another fish down there. Let's get back, and that battery might die. Cool. Well, I'm glad I was able to get that one on camera. So, yeah, not a lot happens at night, guys. I don't have my heater on. That's why my breath is dragon breath right now. Not a whole bunch happens at night. I don't know. Maybe things will turn on later tonight. I don't know. Guess we'll find out because we're going to be here all night, tomorrow morning, maybe lunchtime. We'll see how many fish we catch. Good morning, guys. Or maybe I should say bad morning. Because I'm slowly packing up. I think the universe was trying to tell us something when they when every water that we stopped by was either thin or open. Because, man, another thing went wrong last night. My heater went out. And so I was messing with that for like an hour. And then Butters got up because he missed the fish. He heard me struggling with my heater, so he came over. We ended up swapping heaters, and he said he was willing to sleep without a heater. I was like, man, are you sure? Like, bless this guy, man. Well, we ended up swapping heaters, and my heater worked on his tank, and his heater worked on my tank. And I figured, oh, must be like the hose or something, and he's got a 20 pound, and maybe it pushed everything out. I think an hour into running this heater, it started doing the same thing as my heater. So it's got to be my tank or something, because my hose and heater ran fine on his tank. But the only common denominator is my propane tank. It's got propane in there. But yeah, I'm just slowly packing things up. It's super wet. I think the universe was trying to tell us something. I'm going to pack up. I might stick around and fish because it's still dark. But I'm going to slowly pack things away. I'm not sure how this video is going to turn out. I've been running without a heater for like 3 hours. It's been cold. Got up at like 4:45 because I got cold. Well, I kept getting up, but eventually got to like 4:45. It is 5:15 right now. I figured I might as well get up, try to fish. And then at the same time, it's getting cold. It's like, I might as well just start packing up. Go from there. I don't know what's going to happen, guys. Whew. All right, guys, it is, what time is it? When was the last time we spoke? 6:20, like an hour ago. So I started packing up a few things. Whoop, cut myself off. I packed up a few things. I figured if I wasn't sleeping and if the fish weren't biting, I might as well try to pack up some stuff. Oh, what a night. What a night. I still don't even know if I'm going to make a video. I don't know. Maybe try to catch some panfish or something. Take something home. At least I could cook all that stuff at home. But I'm going to keep packing up. I got a few floor mats, the heater. Yeah. This weekend kind of sucked. Alright, guys. We are back. Oh, man. So much water on the ice and snow. Probably got like an inch of water on top of the snow. But I'm back. Try to catch a few more fish. Oh, he sees me. There he is. I know it's not the best angle for you guys, but... Oh, no. Not these guys. But he was aggressive. Alright, chow. Here we go, guys. A freaking doo-doo day crappie. Oh, he's coming. Upbit it. Not big though. Small guy. Uh-oh. This ain't looking so good. Hopefully the fish will start moving here soon. Not sure how long I'm gonna film because I put all my batteries away. I didn't think about keeping some batteries around. Well, I guess I got that one down there. course. Oh, camera still is on. Yeah, I fished a little bit closer towards the brush pile and this guy was cruising on top. Came zooming in. Chill. There we go. Decent little crappie. Oh, it's so awkward just standing like this. I don't know if you guys can see, but yeah. Alright guys, you guys are fogging up, but Butter's just hooked up with a big fish. Big fish. Nice fish, dude.
Big walleye, guys.
Big walleye.
On a drastic plastic.
Tiny little plastic.
Nice fish, man. He didn't crush it. I just saw him come up to my bait and I kept slowly lifting it. And the weight was there. Set the hook.
Damn.
Got him.
Damn walleye, lucky.
Alright, back in the hole she's going, guys.
Release into the knot grease. Oh shoot, their camera head fell down.
What happened? You ready?
Yeah.
Get her head in there, get her drinking, get her breathing here.
Don't put your phone down.
It's fine.
Chair.
Okay. There you go, get those fins.
Oh yeah, fins are moving.
She's gonna catch. There she goes.
Oh,
healthy release, baby.
Damn, lucky. Everything's all foggy. No. Could just be the LCD too.
Dude, he tangled my dad's stick.
Yeah. All right, guys, I just got back. I'm talking to Butters. Got a big fish too, Butters. Yeah, he's on. Oh. Big walleye, big walleye.
Walleye.
Might be the fish you just let go.
Walleye.
Yeah. Oh, watch out for the trouble.
Well, I was just gonna scoop. There it goes.
It's okay.
I was gonna scoop him.
It's okay.
You hit the crappie head?
Yeah, crappie count. Dude, I just got back.
I was gonna say, I should have scooped him.
It's all good. He would not get his head up. It's okay. It's okay, Butters.
I got wet for you, kid.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Oh, dude. Well, you guys couldn't see it, but man, we had a big crappie on there just now. Or not a big crappie, big walleye. It's okay. Two fails. So I finally hooked up with Big Kitty earlier. Filled on recording. Now that one, we could not get his head up the hole. Kept trying to bring his head back, but we couldn't get him up. Man, it's all right though. It's all right. At least I saw him. It was a pretty nice one. Whew, man. All right. Well, I'm back home. I'm super sore. My back hurts. And I was pretty tired. I took a nap. And now I'm ready to clean some fish. But man. That was rough last night. I don't know if I got that point across, but I don't want to be all super negative because I do not want to put a bummer of a video out there. So, back at home, gonna clean those fish, try to do those lettuce wraps. I don't know if I talked about that, but I'm gonna try to do it now. Try to cook some fish the old school way, fillet some of them. Oh, try to see which one's better. Probably do some kind of time lapse or something. Maybe I'll show you guys how to clean a fish traditionally. And then just time lapse the rest because you guys seen flames and my roommate's creeping back there making me nervous. Dar? Anyways, let's clean some fish. Alright, let's see. We're gonna do one traditional and then one filleted. Maybe two filleted. But don't mind this guy right here. I end up catching a crappie and hooking up with a good walleye with one of these pieces. Just pretend I didn't cut these guys up for bait. It's not a total waste because, we're going to fry these guys up. I thought about using these guys for the whole fish, but I think I'm going to do fins on for the whole fish. So we'll just clean these guys old school way. And these spoons are like the best for scaling fish. Actually, two of the best things about ice fishing is that you can throw the fish outside in a bucket, or just throw snow in a bucket, and these guys are super fresh though. Some of these guys are from last night, and you probably wouldn't be able to tell which ones. Oh, maybe that guy,
because he's a little bit more dried out. But like the rest of these, you know, could tell you I caught these guys half an hour ago. Anywho, let's get one scaled. So with these Asian spoons, well, you get a whole bunch of scales going at once. So we're gonna try to get all the scales off. I'm gonna keep the fins on because fried fins are surprisingly good, you know. Don't knock it till you rocked it, so don't be all like, ew, gross. It's like, I was gonna say Asian chips, it's fish chips. I think for the most part, that's it. I think that is it. Then I'm gonna go ahead and gut this guy. And these fish are still super cold. So we're gonna cut back behind the gills. Or in front of the gills. Then kinda back here. Around the gills. Go straight down the middle. I don't know if this is advertiser friendly, but we'll see. And we'll cut off where the gills are connected to the roof of the mouth. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if this stuff will be advertiser friendly. So, and you should be able to grab all this. And mostly should come out. Oh, well, it didn't. There's the liver. Who's got eggs in there? I'm gonna leave the eggs in there. How about that? Because I know people that eat fish the traditional way, they'll be like, no, don't throw away the eggs. And then other people are like, ugh, eat the eggs, that's gross. But it's not terrible. Not for everybody, but it's not terrible. Then we'll just rinse this guy out. And you know what? I'm gonna soak him in some salt water. Hold on, let me pull out this connective tissue. All right, so now we're gonna take some salt and cold water and mix it together. Sure, it's not an exact science. Just put salt in water. Since I'm gonna flay some fish anyways, I might as well score this fish. Sure, and then I think traditionally they'll do a cross section too. Because the idea is that once you fry these guys, you're gonna be able to pull these chunks off. We'll do the other side. There we go. So when we go to fry this guy, all these little scores are gonna fry up quickly and be extra crispy. Then I just put them in that salt bath over there. Okay. And I think I'm gonna fillet the rest. Maybe I'll do one more traditional. Yeah, I'll do one more traditional. Yeah. All right, I won't need to show you guys all that, but maybe I'll throw in a time lapse or something. Well, just got done cleaning all the fish. I'm gonna give them a quick wash, rinse them off, and then I'm gonna put them in another salt bath. I should have just did the salt bath at the end and just used plain water because it's kind of redundant when I already did it, because I'm gonna rinse them all off because they're all slimy and scaly right now. And then I'll put them into the salt bath, which is what I should have done in the beginning. And I know, before you say anything, I could have done a better fillet job on the on those crappies. I could have gotten the belly meat and stuff, but I was in a hurry and I was being lazy. It is what it is. I guess I'm gonna eat whole fried fish to make up for it. Anyways, we'll catch up after I get all this stuff cleaned up, fish washed, fish soaking. We'll be right back. All right, guys, so I'm gonna get ready to dry these fish off. So one of the main things when you're gonna fry fish is you wanna dry everything off. Get rid of as much moisture as you can. Put some paper towels on top. Let that sit there for, I don't know, 10 minutes. Let the paper towels soak up as much moisture as they can. And then when I get ready to closer to fry, I can just pat them dry real good and pick up any remaining moisture. Oh, it's gonna be interesting. I haven't done whole fish like this in a long time. So it's been a few minutes. And I think I'm just gonna pat these dry, so I'm getting hungry. It is 5:30, almost dinner time. So they're still kind of moist. So I'm gonna use the dry side of these. Dry these out as best I can. Try to get up all up in that body cavity. Let me zoom you guys in. Dry out the fins, because the fins retain a lot of moisture. The fillets, it's a little easier because they dry out a lot faster. Try to get up any moisture up in here, because any moisture is gonna be popping once it gets into that hot oil. So we're just gonna salt and pepper this guy. A little bit of salt. Rub it in there. Could get fancy and put like garlic powder, onion powder, all that stuff on here. But we'll keep it simple because we got the dipping sauce. Oh yeah, get inside the cavity too. Because we got the dipping sauce that'll add most of the flavor. Cool. So that guy's ready. Gonna heat up some oil. And these guys, I'll just toss into a bag of batter. And you guys have seen that a million times. All right, that sounds good. I don't know if you guys can hear that. There we go. So we're gonna cook this up. I'm gonna turn, I'm gonna stop talking because I'm gonna turn on the vent. It's gonna be all loud, but here it goes. Okay guys, the fish are done frying. Are done frying? But here we go. We got the old school whole fish, and we got the new school fish fillets. So I'm gonna set this on the table. I still gotta make the noodles. I'll be right back. So if you guys been following my channel for a while, mee goreng, traditionally this dish is made with vermicelli noodles. But mee goreng is a lot easier, it's a lot quicker. Vermicelli, you gotta babysit it, you gotta sit there and stir it. Otherwise, it's gonna stick to the bottom of your pan or stick to each other. Rinse them out, dry them, curl them up, make them look all nice. But this, 5-10 minutes right here, maybe 5 minutes. Just boil water, put the noodles in, pour the noodles out, mix in the ingredients. That's it. Easy, no babysitting, instant noodles. And they taste pretty awesome. I guess I should show people that have never done it before. Wow, I totally forgot to hit record, but the water's boiling. Put the noodles in there. Make sure you don't throw these guys in, because you're supposed to open them up and put them in afterwards. So don't put this in yet. All right, this has literally been like 2 minutes, and I don't like my noodles too soft. So I'm going to go ahead and take them off, because they're going to finish cooking. Since they're still hot, we're gonna go over to the sink. We're gonna dump these noodles out, or dump the water out. Don't need to rinse them. I guess if you really wanted to, you could rinse it, but that's fine. I'm just gonna keep them in this bowl too. And you wanna leave a little water in there, just a little bit. We're gonna take the dry seasonings. No, you stupid. Usually a tear is pretty easy, but not today. And we'll do the wet. So there's like silasa or sriracha sauce, as some people say. It's like a sweet soy sauce, and this is just seasoning oil. It literally says seasoning oil on there. I'm just gonna cut these open. Do a little bit of the oil, maybe half of it, not all of it. Go ahead and toss these. God, don't mind me. And we're just gonna mix all this together. That's it. Easy, way easier than the vermicelli. And if you really wanna spice things up, you can add more silasa, which I sometimes do. But if you really wanna spice things up, use this guy right here. Burn your booty hole the next day for sure. So I'm not gonna do that. I think my pineapple sauce is burn your booty hole status already. So, yeah. All right. Wait, where did I grab chopsticks? Got chopsticks right there. This is what I meant to grab. A spoon. Let's put our lettuce wrap together. It's kind of a variation on what they call panpa. It's basically fish wrap for all the non-Lao speaking people. But over here I got some lettuce, cucumber, tomato, and cilantro. So during this whole camping thing, the original plan was to do all this out on the ice, except for maybe the whole fish part, because fillets are just easier. But I figured since I'm at home, take my time. So we're gonna put this together. Bed of lettuce, romaine lettuce helps. I think you can use any lettuce. Just makes it nice and easy. Put down some cucumber. Put down a couple stalks of cilantro. Few tomatoes. I know it's a lot going on, but it's like a party in your mouth. And we'll go ahead and a couple pieces of fish. The veggie to fish ratio is pretty high on this one. Okay, so I got three pieces of fish on there. And this is a tomato, or not tomato, pineapple sauce. It's got pineapple, ginger, garlic, chili peppers, fish sauce, fermented fish sauce, MSG, what else? Sugar. It's a pretty easy sauce. I wasn't sure how it was gonna turn out, so I didn't make a tutorial, but maybe I could put like ingredients and amounts and steps on how to make the sauce. But used to eat it all the time as a kid, and just growing up, I got away from it, but made it for the first time, and I think it turned out pretty good. So we're gonna put that on here. Ooh. The good thing about this sauce, it's not super runny, so it won't get everywhere like my other sauce that you guys see me eat. So let's try the lettuce wrap. You know, I might put more sauce on here. This sauce smells so good, like pineapple and ginger. The fermented fish sauce is kind of funky on its own, but once you put it in stuff, I don't even notice it. It just, I don't know, I think the flavor profile is like umami. Kind of like a savory taste. So here we go. It's like so fresh, pretty light, even though it's fried fish, but with all the veggies, herbs, cucumber, tomato, the pineapple sauce, it is super refreshing. And now time to do a comparison with the Asian style or traditional style way of cooking fish. So we'll start out the fin. It's surprisingly good. It's like eating chips. If you've never done it, you might like it. Salty, crispy. Let's try the fish on its own. Salty, crispy. You do have to look out for bones though when you do it this way. So it's not the most ideal dish for kids, frying it this way. What our parents would normally do is they would just pick out the meat for us. It's not a beer. It's not a beer. It's Sunday night. Gotta work tomorrow. But Asian drink to go with my Asian meal. Soy milk, soybean drink. It's pretty good. I know a lot of people think soybean drinks weird, but it isn't like your American soy milk. It's actually got flavor. It's kind of sweet, actually. Having a hard time here. Good thing it's just me. So all those scores I did with the fish, I'm just gonna pick at those. There's a little chunk there. We'll do like three or four chunks. Cucumber, tomato. I'm not even that big of a fan of tomato, and just throw it into something like this and you barely even notice it. Cilantro, some sauce. Man, I gotta take a picture of this. All right, let's see the classical way of frying fish on this. If I had to guess, it's gonna be good either way. All right. That was pretty good. If I had to pick one, as far as just strictly flavor, I think the traditional way wins. It's just got more flavor. Maybe it's the salt and the pepper. And the fillets just got a light coating of, Whisker Seeker batter? Yeah, the traditional way has more flavor. As far as prep and ease of eating, fillets wins hands down. You know what? Gotta look for them eggs. I don't know, there's some connective tissue there. Might be a little funky. Here we go. Fish, crappie caviar. Crappie roe. Not bad. It probably won't be for everybody. I mean, I've had crappie eggs before, so it isn't that surprising to me, but it just tastes like fried stuff. But anywho, this video is gonna be all over the place, or it has been all over the place, so I apologize for that. Hopefully I can put it together in some cohesive manner. But man, ice camping was rough. It was a rough night, heater problems, whatever. I'm just complaining and ranting right now, but would I camp again? I don't know. I'm not fussed over the night fishing because it was basically a lot of sitting around and staring at a blank screen. But if you got people with you, you know, go out there, catch up with old friends, drink beer, or whatever it is you do. But this was pretty dang good. I'm gonna sit here and finish up this fish, probably do a couple more wraps. And if you guys liked it, give it a like. If you want to see more stuff like this, let me know. And if you want to see more videos, hit that subscribe button. I don't know why I started doing that, but see ya.